Hello students, in this video we are going to study about gymnosperms. Gymnosperms, in which gymno means naked and sperm means seeds. The plants who have naked seeds are called gymnosperms. These are also referred as phanerogams because in phanerogams or in gymnosperms the ovules are not enclosed, that is they are naked. And they are not enclosed by any ovarian wall and they are exposed even after or before fertilization. After fertilization or post fertilization, seeds are not enclosed, that is why they are called as naked seeds. Gymnosperms includes medium sized trees like tall trees or shrubs. The tallest tree species known in gymnosperms is giant redwood tree, that is sequoia tree. Since gymnosperms are vascular plants, so they have well differentiated vascular tissues in roots, leaves and stem. Now coming to the root. In gymnosperms, the root is taproot. In most gymnosperms there is the presence of taproot, which have the fungal association, that is the mycorrhiza. For example, in case of pinus, there are some trees who have special roots called coralloid roots, which helps in the nitrogen fixation, and that is carried out by blue green algae or cyanobacteria. For example, in case of cycas. Stems. The stems of gymnosperms are either unbranched or branched. If the stems are unbranched, then the example of unbranched stem is like that of cycas. And branched stem is found in case of pinus or siderus. Now coming to the leaves of gymnosperms. The leaves of gymnosperms may be simple or compound, and there are also some plants that are coming in gymnosperms who have pinnate leaves that persist for few years. For example, in case of cycas, these leaves are well adapted to withstand the extreme temperatures or humidity and wind. That means these plants are going to have some modification in their leaves so that they can withstand the extreme temperature of cold or any other extreme temperatures. For example, in case of conifers, the conifers have needle like leaves to withstand the extreme cold, and they have thick cuticle and sunken stomata so that they can reduce the water loss from the leaf. Gymnosperms are heterosporous plants that produces haploid microspores and haploid megaspores, and these spores are produced in the sporangia, where these sporangia born on sporophylls, which are spirally arranged along an axis to form lax or compact structure called strobili and cones. Now these strobili bears megasporophylls or microsporophylls. These megasporophylls or the microsporangia are also called as male microsporangiate or male strobili that produces microspores. These microspores develop into male gametophyte generation, which is highly reduced and confined, and they are produced in very limited numbers. then these reduced gametophyte are going to produce, the reduced gametophyte is called pollen grains. These pollen grains are developed within the microsporangia, which is from which the microspores are produced. It is a sporing body from which microspores are produced. And since they are microspores, therefore it will lead to the formation of a male gametophyte. Other one is megasporophyll. The cones that bear megasporophylls with ovules or megasporangia are called macrosporangiate or female strobili. The male or female strobili, if they are present, they may be present on the same tree, for example in case of pinus. These male and female strobili may also be present on different trees, for example in case of cycas. As we are aware about in cases of bryophytes, the male and female sex organs were present on the same plant. But in case of gymnosperms, they have the free living existence. They live on same plant also, yeah, same tree also, or on the different trees also. Now, the spore, megaspore mother cell divides mitotically and it will lead to the formation of 4 megaspores. After this megaspore mother cell differentiated from any of the cells of the mucilus is microsporangia, megasporangia, from which it has been differentiated, and this mucilus is protected by envelope and a composite structure called ovule. Where these ovules are born on a megasporophylls that lead to the formation of female cones. Let me describe once again. These female strobili produces megaspores or megaspore mother cell, which differentiated in mucilus and leads to the formation of ovules that are protected in a envelope or compact structures. These ovules are born on megasporophylls, which produces female cones. Now, as we have already discussed that when this megaspores divides mitotically, or it will have the reduction division, then it will lead to the formation of 4 megaspores. One of the megaspores enclosed within the megasporangium develops into multicellular gamete that bears 2 or more archegonia or female sex organs. Then this multicellular female gamete is retained within the megasporangium. As we are aware that bryophytes and pteridophytes, they are not free living, they have the male and female gametophytes altogether, but in case of pteridophytes, they are the independent free living existence. So the sporangia that are obtained on the sporophytes, these pollen grains that are formed by microsporangia are released from the microsporangium with the help of air currents. It comes in contact with the ovule. Pollen grains from the microsporangia comes in contact with ovule, and this ovule then lead to the formation of a zygote, where the pollen grains form a pollen tube that reaches to the ovules, and with this there is a formation of a zygote that develops into an embryo and the ovules into seeds, and the seeds that are produced from the ovules are naked or not covered by any ovarian wall. This is the life cycle of the gymnosperms, which are heterosporous in nature and independent free living existence. With this we finishes off gymnosperms. Thank you.